All right, so what I'm figuring we're going to find. We already know that's bad. So there's a light adjust. So we've got a bad fuel hose, so just going to replace every piece of rubber hose on this thing. And the story on this truck is they were going to go do a delivery. They pulled it around front to the office where it promptly shut off and would not start again. So I'm going to guess rotted fuel hose caused their problem to start with, not to mention this leaking fuel pump. And the starter was, I can't remember if I made a video on that or not, starter was just roasted. I've never seen one cook like this before. Seen plenty of arcing, but never seen one cooked before. So that's one of those things where somebody's cranking and it's going rrr, 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 and they just hold the key on and they keep going rrr, 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 rrr. And you stand over in the side of the parking lot going, it's not going to start! Well, now that I've taken all of this hood insulation and removed it from the valley area beneath the intake plenum, I now have to deal with this quarter inch fuel line because it has a gaping hole down there. I think I have to pull this plenum just to replace this hose. I'm not very pleased about that, but the price was right. Well, this is one of those times that the long way is the short way and the short way is the long way. So we're going the long way about it to ensure that we do it the short way. And away we go. A special thanks to William, because nothing takes the drudgery out of this like having a Milwaukee. Oh, it's such a beautiful thing. Oh. Okay, things can fall down here. I should acquire a tub. It's a stud, that's a stud. Stud, bolt. Oh, there's the matter of the injector lines. Theoretically, you should be able to pull it off there. After all, the injector lines have to go in first, come out last. So I need a 13 for that right there. I need 16 or 17 back on the back. What a great truck. It's too high to, from just standing on the ground without some sort of stool or crawling under the hood. And it's too low to the ground to work underneath it without having to jack it up, put it on stands. Oh, no, 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 no. About destroyed my grounds. Now I've got to try to hold the stud. Either that or I'm going to end up cutting these grounds, which it looks like somebody already did once. Because they got the yeller connectors on them. So the stud is in there, they put a nut on, which is not metric, so they bound it down, and now the nut doesn't want to come off without backing the stud out, which means it's clamped down on the ground leads, which are just going to spin around the thing when you go to take it off. This is why I dread these things. Exactly why. I'm just going to have to whip it off of there. And I'm going to tell you what, this hurts my knees. I can take that off at the firewall, which it looks like a 10 millimeter, and I won't have to do other stuff. There's what we're talking about. Pop up the injector line retainers. I done blowed it all out already. I'll bet a little spray lube on there would be helpful about now.
Like it.
Remove the plenum. Well, hoping to save the gasket. I'm just cheap that way. Let's see, if I'm standing over here at the fender, reaching out across to the center of the truck, then that 12-pound intake plenum weighs about 250 to the lower back. I need to get a little closer. Well, I only weigh 12 pounds when you're sitting right on top of it. Why? It's got enormous chew marks in it. Like that. All because of rats. Well, we'll have all new fuel hoses when we're done.
New lines on. Electrical connector fixed. It's hiding down there. You can barely see it.
Number one, yes. It would been nice to check for leaks before I stuck this on, but I am confident in my ability. And number two, yes, I took care of the intake gaskets. Don't you worry about a thing. Now, which bolts went where? Oh, that wasn't good. I know these big, long, tall ones go here. Oh, I forgot one. It's still over there in the vise. The one that I took the thing off of there. Electrical connector. I dropped something on the floor, and I gotta climb down and go find out what it was. And no, I'm not going to zip them down in there with the Milwaukee either. Oh, come on. You will get on. Oh, I'm never as young as I used to be.
Well, there you go. Click 16 times. That's all you're going to get this time around. All right, time for left fuel pump. Crawl underneath. Oh, you know what? I think before I do this, I found the fuel hose was quite nasty. And I'm just thinking, that's where it could have been leaking. Not out of the pump itself. So, I'm gonna try one of those first. Sound like it's picking up fuel. Hope I didn't hook it up backwards. There it goes.
Pumping. Coming up to pressure. No leakages. Oh, it was my fuel hose. A whole lot cheaper than the $40 fuel pump. Yes, I have my drain pan conveniently located below there.
There. That's what we like to hear. Purge that air.
Yeah. Gonna call that good one more time over here. And steady. I think we're primed.
Obviously, it was able to drive up here under its own power, even though it had the leak in the inlet side of the pump. Oh.
it coming.
That should help. What's that? That the long way is the short way and the short way is the long way. So we're going the long way about it to making sure ensure exactly what I didn't want to happen. Oh, come on now. Somebody put a different nut on it. Great. Some of you can imagine how much this hurts my knees. Others of you might speak to us. Tell you what, this hurts my knees. Now, can you see the back one? Cramping. Like it's picking up fuel. Hope it didn't hook it up backwards. I'm sure I had the arrow go in the right direction. Yes, the arrow is definitely in the right direction. Come on, pick up fuel, will ya?
Okay.
Can you hear me?
Yep.